Hey guys, hope you're fine and welcome to my Excel tutorial channel. And today we'll be doing the advanced techniques of count functions. So if you haven't subscribed to this channel, do subscribe it because we're gonna cover so much in this video. And let's get started. So if you haven't watched our basics of counting functions, then you should do it because it is related to that. But we are not gonna cover the basics of counting function or any count function because we have done it in our channel. So this is the next step towards it, and in this video we're gonna count errors in function using the count formula, right? Count function, right? And we will do the two criterias, which is the AND criteria using the count ifs and OR criteria using the count if. And we will know the differences between the count if and count ifs and count functions. And we will also use the helpers for functions in this video, like len function, which is gonna find the length of particular value, or is error functions, which is gonna cover in the count errors. So let's get started into the first part, which is count errors in Excel. So here it is. So we have this range. So here is the demo data for you, and we have this. We have incurred 3 errors here. You may get more, or 3 or 4 or 5, 6 errors if you haven't watched the error. If you want to understand each and every error of the Excel, then you can watch our video, which we have covered each and every error in it. So in this video, what we're gonna do first, we have incurred 3 errors. This is the demo data because this is only a 6 or 7 values here, but you can have like thousands of values in your worksheet. Then it's hard to count those errors basically with the help of the basic functions. So in what we're gonna do is to identify errors, which function we can use. There are various error functions also in Excel. So in this, let's do with the basics. So what we're gonna do is to count the, you know, to identify the errors in our range, what we're gonna do is we're gonna use isError function. So with isError function, it will revert back the true or false if this particular cell contains an error or not. It will give my answer. So here I will select this range in the value argument and close it, and here we go. We will get the true. Yes, we got the reference error in this cell, so it's true, and false because it's not giving any error. And here division error is true and name error is true. So these are the true and false, but this is the demo data and you don't want to, you know, count like this in your worksheet. You just want to count where it is and how much errors in your worksheet. So if you want to count on the basis of this is error, you can do it with the help of count if. Like here I will select the range. Here we got the 2 arguments here, b1 to b7, right? And what will be the criteria? I will count only the true value because true value give me the errors. So in quote format I will write the true, and here we go, we got the 3. Yes, we got the 3. So the solution is simple, we got what we needed. But this will give us very, you know, 2 or 3 steps to calculate it. What about in single steps? How are we gonna do that? We can modify this formula. What we're gonna do is we will input here the if function. See, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the count function and if function. What does the count function do? They only calculate, or they only count the values, right? So with the help of if function, so if function is a logical function, as you know. If this is right, then what will be the value, and if this is wrong, and then what will be the value? We will put here the 3 arguments here. Logical test, it's already given, right, with the is error function. And if value is revert true, then what will be the outcome? So I will write here 1, okay. And what value if false, I will and nothing, and just quote unquote it, right? It will just leave it blank. And here we go. So as you can see, we got 1 1 1 where it gives me an error, right? The where the value was true, it gave me a 1 1. Now with the help of count function, we will count all the valid values. So we will add the count function here, Okay, so we add the count function here, and we got the value 1, and here we got all the arguments we needed in our function. So here we go, the 3, you got the answer. So it was that simple. Yes, I have explained you from the step by step how to deal with such situation, so you can adopt any method to count your errors in your Excel. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, please do subscribe it before getting into the next video. Do like this video and subscribe, and do share if you want to help others to understand this. So see you in the next video.